Have you ever wondered how the lengthy tunnels on the HS2 route are being constructed? If so, then stick around and I'll do my best to explain the process, which is incredibly fascinating. I've spoken about HS2 tunnels before and explained some of the basic principles, but I've never had a chance to get close to some of the other machinery used to construct the tunnels until now. I have been on board a TBM and was even there when TBM Caroline was launched to construct part of Northolt Tunnel. But the TBM is only one of many pieces of equipment which are required to build a tunnel. The TBM, or tunnel boring machine, is the thing that does all of the excavation, and it is also used to assemble the tunnel rings. The TBM is in effect a mobile tunnel building factory, which moves itself forward using hydraulic rams, which push against the tunnel ring which has just been assembled. A tunnel ring, if you haven't watched one of my videos before, is a ring which is made out of precast concrete segments, which are used to line the tunnel. Usually around 7 individual segments are used to construct each ring, which usually have an internal diameter on the HS2 route ranging from 7.5 meters to 9 meters. In the case of Bromford Tunnel, almost 21,000 individual segments are being manufactured off-site in Avonmouth, with manufacturing taking place at a factory which was previously used to construct the ring segments for the Hinkley C water intake pipes. These segments are transported to the site by road and are then stored on the surface close to the tunnel portal. Manufacturing the segments and managing their delivery is a complex process, requiring specific molds depending on the shape of the ring, with these segments having to be stored in a specific order so they are delivered ready to construct a specific ring. This is because each segment has a different shape, which is used to form the curves of the tunnel and also controls the direction of the TBM as it pushes against the ring to move forward. When needed, these segments are lowered from the surface into the tunnel portal by a gantry crane or crawler crane. These segments are then transported to the TBM on board multi-service vehicles, or MSVs. These specialist vehicles can carry 7 ring segments, which have a combined weight of up to 45 tons. The MSV can also transport grout, which is used to fill small voids between the tunnel wall and ring. Other MSVs are used to transport pipes and other equipment, while some are outfitted to transport cable drums and have remote controlled cranes on board, which are sometimes referred to as HIABs. There are also MSVs which are used to shuttle workers to and from TBMs. This is a vital task, as the walk to TBM Mary Ann would now take up to 45 minutes, eating into valuable shift time. Mary Ann, which is one of 2 TBMs constructing Bromford Tunnel, has now completed half of the 5.8 kilometer long drive. So, walking almost 3 kilometers to and from the TBM, even at a brisk pace, would take a considerable amount of time out of a 12-hour shift. The MSVs are able to drive forwards and backwards and have cabs at either end. The reason for this should be fairly obvious, as trying to do a 3-point turn within a tunnel wouldn't be practical or even possible given the length of the vehicles. To load the segments onto the TBM, the MSV first has to be driven into the rear part of the TBM. Then a crane, which uses suction, picks the segments up and stores them on board the TBM. Then, when they're needed, a remote control suction lifter lifts the segments and manoeuvres them into position to build the ring. Whilst MSVs are used to supply the equipment, rings and workers, there is the not-so-small task of removing the excavated material still to do. In this instance, it is Mercia mudstone, which is mixed with water to form a slurry. This slurry is then pumped to the surface and processed, with the filtered water returning back to the TBM cutter head. Once the mudstone slurry has been dried, it is moved by articulated dump trucks, otherwise known as ADTs, to other parts of the HS2 site. A slurry system was also used during the construction of the Chiltern Tunnel. However, the TBMs excavating Northolt Tunnel used conveyors to transport loose material the full length of the tunnel to the surface. None of the 1.8 million cubic metres of material that will be excavated will go to waste, and it has been trucked north along a purpose-built haul road to Delta Junction, where it is being used for earthworks and landscaping. I'm hoping to release a video about Delta Junction later this year, so make sure you subscribe so you don't miss that video. As mentioned previously, the TBM moves forward by pushing against the previously assembled ring, and at the same time the cutter head reduces the face of the tunnel to rubble, before the material is turned into slurry. The TBM can progress by as much as 40 metres each day, which may sound slow, but when you consider that the 1,600 tonne machine is excavating and building the tunnel at the same time, then it really is quite impressive. Although a lot of automated systems are used, the TBM is still staffed by a specialist team of 180 workers, who work in shifts to keep the TBMs operating 24 hours a day, 7 days a week. With Marianne now at the halfway stage, it is hoped it'll reach the Western Tunnel portal by early 2025, and will then be followed by Elizabeth towards the middle of the same year. I made two separate videos about the Western Portal and Washwood Heath Depot, which are worth watching if you haven't already. Whatever your opinions are about HS2, I don't think many people would fail to be impressed by the engineering required to build a new high-capacity north-south railway. Even after spending the last 2 years covering many aspects of HS2, I'm always awestruck when I'm fortunate enough to get on site. Speaking of, I must say thank you to the HS2 media team and Balfour Beatty Vinci Joint Venture for the invite to the Bromford East Portal site. And just before I sign off, I would like to say a big thank you to my Patreon and YouTube supporters who helped make it possible for me to continue to make content such as this. Your continued support really is appreciated.